Hey, data science professionals, welcome back to my channel. Are you feeling anxious about your upcoming phone screening with a technical recruiter? Don't worry, you're definitely not alone. As a data scientist, you might be a total expert at crunching numbers and analyzing data, but when it comes to selling yourself as a candidate, it can be a whole different ballgame. In this video, we'll dive into how to prep for a technical recruiter phone screen, specifically as a data scientist. This topic comes up a lot. And I totally get it. It can be nerve-wracking. But I've got some clear action items and practical tips that will help you feel confident going into that conversation. We'll cover not only how to prep, but also I will give you the script to answer some tricky salary-related questions. I hope it helps you with preparing for your next interview. Now, let's get into it. First, let's start by clarifying the role of a recruiter. I want to start with a change of my own perspective on recruiters. When I first started looking for jobs, I believed that recruiters were the gatekeepers of a company, and their interests conflicted with mine. I thought that they set a high bar and screened candidates like me to prevent us from continuing the interview process. However, after conducting numerous interviews and working with many recruiters, I realized that I was completely wrong. I have a recruiter friend who was shocked when I explained my understanding to her. She shared with me that the recruiter's role is to guide you through the interview process, provide insights into the company's culture and team environment, and answer any questions you have. They view you as a talent and want to help you succeed in your job search. Once I understood this, I focused on building a good relationship with the recruiter. I made sure to be responsive to their communications and ask them to hop on call to share more details about the upcoming interviews and how I could best prepare. And every recruiter I worked with was happy to help. By leveraging the recruiter's expertise, I was able to gain valuable insights into the interview process and present myself in the best light. I realized that many people probably think what I used to think, so I thought it would be helpful to first clarify the role of the recruiter. The recruiter is your friend. They're on your side. They view you as a valuable talent and are there to help you land the job. They are not someone to be feared. Unless you bomb the phone screening, they are going to move you along the interview process. Now that you know the role of a recruiter, what can you do to prepare for the phone screening? Start by preparing a self-introduction. Keep it short and sweet so that you catch their attention in the first 30 seconds. Highlight your most relevant data science skills, experiences, and achievements. Tailor your introduction to the specific job you're applying for, as this will help the recruiter see how your background aligns with the company's needs. It's helpful to study the job description to understand the role's key responsibilities, skills, and qualifications. Don't forget to emphasize how you can contribute to the company and why you're the perfect fit for the role. A mistake I frequently see is that many people talk about how the job fits their needs instead of how they fit the company's needs. So it's always best to start with a brief overview of your background, followed by a few examples of your achievements or experiences that demonstrate your qualifications for the role. For example, you're applying for a product data scientist role that requires specific skills like A/B testing and SQL. You can talk about how you lead A/B testing projects in your current company and use SQL on a daily basis. This will show that you can contribute to the company from day one. To guide you through the process of introducing yourself to a recruiter, check out my video on how to introduce yourself in data science interviews. Keep in mind that your self-introduction should be memorable and engaging, so try to incorporate your unique personality and voice into it. Remember, this is a phone call, so the recruiter cannot see you, which means you need to convey your energy and enthusiasm through your voice. Speak clearly and slowly and show that you're excited about that opportunity. One helpful tip is to record yourself when preparing for the phone call. You can play it back to ensure that you're engaging when introducing yourself. Ask yourself, do I sound excited or do I sound bored? This can help you identify areas where you can improve and make sure that you are presenting yourself in the best possible light. After mastering your self-introduction, the next step is to ensure you are well prepared to discuss your resume comprehensively. This involves delving into your work experience, education, and skills with specific examples to illustrate. how they've prepared you for the position you're applying for. It's a good idea to think of a couple of data science projects that you have worked on in the past that you can discuss in detail during the conversation. For example, if you're applying for a marketing data scientist position, you might discuss a specific marketing campaign or media mix model you developed that was successful in driving sales or increasing brand awareness. If you're applying for a machine learning data scientist role, you could talk about a machine learning project you worked on that solved a complex business problem and drove business growth. I think this might be obvious to most of you, but I want to point out that many people make the mistake of focusing too much on the technical details of their projects. While it's important to show your technical skills, recruiters may not always understand or appreciate the technical challenges. Instead, focus on conveying the impact of your work using numbers and business metrics that anyone can understand. This will demonstrate the value you can bring to the company in a tangible way. In addition to discussing your past projects, recruiters often ask behavioral questions to gauge your fit within the company culture. To prepare for this, practice answering questions about teamwork, problem solving, and communication. Here are some examples of the top behavioral questions that you might encounter in a recruiter phone call. Why ask, what are you looking for in your next role? What does a good team look like to you? What are some of your long-term and short-term professional goals? What are some challenges you have faced while working at your current company? Based on my own experience working with over 100 data scientists in the past few years, I've noticed that people are better at talking about their experience and skill sets, but less effective at answering those behavioral questions. To increase your chances of success, I really recommend practicing these questions out loud and having some solid answers written out. Prepare some notes or keywords to have handy by you when you're on the phone so you can refer to them. Apart from being prepared to answer non-technical behavioral questions, be ready to answer some technical questions, even during a phone screening with the recruiter. Some of you might assume that recruiters aren't in a technical position, so you may not be as prepared for a technical interview as you would be for phone screening. But here's the thing. Some companies train recruiters to ask technical questions, even if recruiters are not experts themselves. Why, you might ask? Well, they want to make sure that candidates have the right technical skills for the job and can speak about the experience and expertise in a clear and concise way. Typically, the technical questions asked during phone screening are not in-depth. From my own experience and from what other data scientists have shared with me, there are simple product case statistics and SQL questions recruiters may ask. Usually, if the question is open-ended, they have rubrics to check if your answers hit some points. If the question has more specific answers, they will have the right answers. So don't be caught off guard when a recruiter asks you about a product case question or a statistics question or other technical questions. It's helpful to be familiar with the technical skills and the requirements of the job and be prepared to answer technical questions. Now you know what to expect. You will be better prepared than most candidates to tackle questions that come your way during the phone screening. Now, picture this. You're having a great phone screening with a recruiter. Everything's going smoothly, and then they hit you with a big question. What are your salary expectations? It's a question that can catch you off guard and leave you feeling unsure about how to answer. Should you show a range of expected compensation? Or should you keep it vague and see what they offer? Well, here's the thing. During the initial phone screening with the recruiter, it's uncommon for compensation to be discussed immediately. However, if it does come up, you need to be ready with the script for handling those tricky questions. Here's what I suggest. I don't feel comfortable giving a ballpark figure. I believe my skill set is unique, and I am confident that I can perform well in the position that I'm interviewing for. I also believe that the company can offer competitive pay. Would you mind sharing with me the expected pay range for this position? The main goal here is to be polite, but not let yourself be pressured into giving away your numbers and your negotiating power. Asking the question back will help you get more information and decide if you want to proceed or not. But wait, there's more. Some recruiters may even ask you, if the salary is between X and Y, would you be okay with that? You can respond in the same way and ask for more details. Since the salary is only part of the total compensation, there might be sign-on bonus, stock or RSU, or annual bonus, and etc. in the package, So you can also respond, I will look at the entire package I'm offered upon hiring to determine my decision. Would you mind sharing the range of the total compensation? If the maximum compensation is significantly lower than your expectations, you can then determine if you want to move forward with the opportunity or not. So there you have it. Don't let those tricky salary questions throw you off. Be ready with the polite script and ask questions so that you can make an informed decision about the opportunity at hand. Aside from everything we've discussed, it's also essential to research the company before your interview. This allows you to show your enthusiasm for the company and gain a deeper understanding of its products and services. For instance, what are the company's values and mission statement? If it's a startup, how have they developed, and what are their plans for the future? This is a step that many people tend to skip, but it's essential to know the company, the business they are in, and their products so that you can speak to them. One useful way to research the company is to explore its website and social media channels. Doing so can give you a sense of the company's culture, history, and even their technical stack. In addition, some companies may have data science blogs or other informative resources that you can review to gain insights into their work. By researching the company, you will know their business metrics and you can position yourself as a knowledgeable and committed candidate. Finally, make sure you prepare some questions to ask the recruiter. Have a list of thoughtful questions about the company, team, and the role ready. This will demonstrate your genuine interest and help you evaluate whether the position is a good fit for you. Here are some sample questions for the recruiter. What do you like most about working here? What do you think makes this company's culture unique? Where do you see the company in 5 years? However, it's best to avoid questions about work-life balance and vacation time during your initial interaction with the recruiter. Save those questions for later stages of the interview process when it's more appropriate to discuss them. In summary, we talked about 6 key things to help you rock your recruiter phone screening. Remember, the recruiter is on your side, so don't be afraid to ask questions or seek their input. They can provide you with insights into the company culture, the hiring process, and even tips for acing the next interview stage. Before you go, don't forget to check out my YouTube channel for more interview tips and practical examples specifically for data science professionals like you. If you find this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment sharing your experience, and subscribe to our channel for more career advice and tips. Now go out there and smash that phone screening. Good luck.